Hi guys, it's Mikefield here. I have 5 simple steps for you that will help you rank up to Champion and Darkest. Remember to like, sub and comment if you enjoyed the video. The first step, guys, is the team composition. And my very first piece of advice is don't be a hero. Innovating is awesome, but if you're new to any game, you probably don't understand it too well. The builds you will create at first are very likely to have some serious big flaws that you aren't aware of, because you just don't know the game well enough yet. I got to watch people playing veteran games for a while, and they were often getting smashed super hard and blaming every loss on bad RNG. But the truth is, they were not even getting unlucky. They were simply playing really poor, unrefined compositions all the time, and because of that, their hands were basically tied. So if your deck is trash, you get stuck at some point in every game, no matter how well you play. And compositions are utterly the most important thing in Darkest Dungeon. That's the very first step, that's why it is the very first step here. And you need a solid composition to even learn the game. And the faster you climb up, the faster you meet those stronger opponents, and the sooner you also kind of get exposed to higher levels of play. So you can absorb all this cool knowledge that, you know, those high tier people have simply by getting a refined composition and playing it up to the higher levels. And this is the way you improve. So the question might be where to get the builds from. Well, first of all, obviously, I'm kind of self-advertising here, but I made 2 big guides about them. The links are in the description below. And second of all, you know, watch the streams of higher ranked players and see what their opponents are using. Take those builds, including their skills and trinkets, watch how they're played, adapt them to your own playstyle if you want to, and take them to Ringmaster's Arena. The streamers to watch, in my opinion, are Claude Goliath and, well, me. Not that many people actually stream the circus at high level, as far as I know. So those 2 streamers are your go-to. Now, once you understand how high tier compositions work, you will create your own perfect or quirky team. Before that, however, you need to learn how the circus works indeed. So it will go much faster for you if you just learn from the others. That's how every big game works, or every skill works. So it is just faster and more efficient to learn the skill from somebody else than to figure it out yourself. Think of building a boat, right? You probably can figure out how to build a boat over the course of, let's say, 10 years. But you can just go to somebody who builds boats as their, you know, vocation, and then they will teach you how to do this within like way shorter period of time. Also, remember that every rank has its meta, and you have to adapt to it. So you see a lot of Flagellant and Leper use Abomination with Padlock plus Raitress Net to slam them to 4th, or ABH with the uppercut, right? Getting stunned for years every game, take an Arbalest on the team. Too much stress, Goliath's Leper comp works really well against that. And that's how you do it, guys. You adapt and you learn. The second tip, guys, is the second most important thing, in my opinion. And it is think before you act. And this was my biggest mistake ever when I was a veteran. You have 30 seconds per action per character. This means your turn has 2 minutes in it. So do not act fast and then regret it. Look at the numbers on your right, those are the odds to succeed. Check the enemy dodge and resistances, reassess if you really want to be hitting the target. You know, don't let the timer run out. When planning, imagine what happens if you miss or are resisted. Maybe it's not worth wasting that stunning blow on the 65 dodge shield breaker or a 120 stun resist man-at-arms. Can I make a better use of that character? Or just consider all those things. Consider chances. You want to be dropping Harvest on a Crusader, maybe Darkstab on their Bounty Hunter? That will definitely put more pressure on them and, you know, put you in a better position and facilitate a finale later. So if you learn to consistently think before you move, you will also get to step 3, which is learning the actual game. So before you blame every bad thing that happens to you on RNG, learn how much resistances characters have, what their weak spots are. So for instance, you know, Jester Finale takes double stress damage, right? You have to know all those things if you want to be playing efficiently. And also learn what skill ranges each character has. This will help you a ton to actually make decisions fast, manipulate any information and set them back, and put them out of your comfort zone as well. So also you have to look at your own team, right? So what cool combos do you have? Some fancy push and pull of Abba and BH will put the enemy Leper in 4th on first turn, for instance. So learn what skills you want to prioritize, test if your plan works, rinse and repeat, so improve over time. And then you have to think about what your team's weaknesses are as well, right? So a lap in the front that gets pushed, or, you know, we have to keep an enemy abomination BH stunned, for instance, then, right? Or just push them away. Squishy characters getting one shot with Mark, you know, you need to have an active healer then. And you need to keep them to go last to heal Dev's door or drop regen before the finisher comes down, right? So all those things are very important to keep in mind. And then this basically brings us to step number four, which is read into fights. And the beginning of every fight, read into it. Check enemy trinkets, check their composition and figure out what win conditions they have and you have against them. So people come into a game with a plan in mind. You need to see what their plan is before you make your first move. This basically allows you to disrupt their turn order and perhaps force them to, you know, at least delay their plan. So can you move any of the enemy characters to a bad spot from which they can't act, or their options are limited, or they're forced to move? Do both of you have Crusaders and you started first? Well, if yes, then you start, right? There are quite a few of those little yes or no questions they have to go for every single fight. Is there some squishy backliner without snuff and you have BH in the pool then? And then you have to think about those more complex things, such as, do I really want to push that Crusader? Since, you know, Holy Lance does actually a ton of damage, maybe being stunned isn't that bad as an alternative, right? So you have to just keep asking yourself those questions, figure out your opponent and act on it. And, you know, obviously there will be fights you are very unlikely to win, because the opponent's composition just counters yours. So, for instance, think about the Riposte teams that will often counter AoE teams that use Houndmasters and Antiquarians. And this one you just have to live with. You know, there is some rock, paper, scissors in every game, and lane matchups in League of Legends or Dota, builds in StarCraft 2 just work in the very same way. You may run into something that is, simply speaking, insurmountable for you, even though the skill levels of you and your opponent are basically the same. And then you just have to make the best out of a bad situation. Maybe there is something you haven't tried yet against the enemy build. So for instance, maybe instead of spamming the Festering Vapors with your Antiquarian, it would be good to start using the regeneration, right, across your team. Maybe this keeps you alive long enough to, you know, allow you to just do enough stress and eventually kill your enemy. And you need a team that doesn't get smashed hard by every second thing you meet on the ladder though. So this basically refers you back to step one. Find a composition that isn't countered by virtually everything, or find a composition that isn't only good about against one thing, because this comp will usually just not perform well in, you know, 80-70% of the cases, depending on the meta. Right, so if you get hearts like smashed hard by stress, you cannot just come up with a composition that directly counters stress but works like garbage against everything else. I need a composition that just works against the majority of things, or can win at least against the majority of things that you meet on the ladder. And this means you need to have like this kind of knowledge about the game that initially you probably just don't possess, right? And this basically gets us to step five. And step five is harnessing the RNG. And you need to use your consistency and you need to use your game sense to do this. So you need to understand that RNG in the Butcher Circus is about statistical chances that something happens. If you keep taking those 40% shots and then you complain about bad RNG, I think it's on you. So we tend to, by the way guys, we tend to remember the bad things and forget the good stuff. So don't let the illusion that you're always unlucky take away from your enjoyment of the game or impede your learning process. Right, just think about all the good stuff that happens to you as well. And you have to remember that if you consistently make the correct choices across a large sample of games, you will go up in rank, right? So you have to just manage your chances. And to do that, you need to develop game sense. So you need to understand when you can play safe and go for high percentage plays, and when to play greedy and take risks. This depends on a lot of things. Your team composition, your win conditions, and your opponent's team and win conditions of theirs as well. So if you feel that your win conditions are fading, make those risky plays. If you feel that, you know, their win conditions are crumbling, it's usually okay to play safe and steady. And the thing is, you need to be able to recognize those situations, right? So if you acquire and develop game sense, it will be easier for you to claw your way back into games and close out the ones that you're doing well in. And yes, you will get some bad RNG. You will also get some amazing RNG though. So the important thing is to consistently make the correct choices. If you learn what the right choices are and make them over the course of, say, 10 games, you will see improvement. Finally, guys, learn to bite the bullet. I struggle with this myself, but the idea is that not many games are unwinnable. Adjust on the fly instead of shutting off your brain and crying. It's not easy when you take 60 damage crit in to finish him, I know, but bad things will happen to both you and your opponent. And it's a sign of greatness if you can persevere when the walls are closing in. Also, people suck at closing games out still, even in high ranks, almost 2 months after the release of the circus, so this can be your chance of coming back. Guys, I have a secret 6th step ready for you as well. And that step is play a shitload of games. The more games you play, the more skills you develop. You cannot expect to make a huge progress over the course of 10 or 15 or even 20 games. Like, this will happen across 100 perhaps, right? But if you just, you know, take a sample of 5 games and say, okay, this is not working, this build is garbage, I'm not doing anything right probably, like blah blah, you just give up, this will definitely not get you anywhere, right? Just remember about this. And this being said, prepare for Season 2, and let's get those high ranks, people. And that's gonna be it. So tell me what you think in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, leave me a like. Subscribe if you want more content like this. See you around in the next episodes. See you around in the Butcher Circus, guys. Bye-bye.